part one of this John Williams miniseries will focus on the Big Bang Orchestra brass libraries. Copernicus, Jupiter, Hercules. For those of you too young to remember, this cue comes from the blockbuster movie Jurassic Park, directed by Steven Spielberg, with the musical score written by John Williams. The Big Bang Orchestra brass series is well suited for this music. While I'm only working off a reduced score I found online, I was able to cobble together an authentic performance because of the realism of these libraries. Copernicus was recorded as trumpets A4, meaning four trumpets in unison, playing at the same time. Captured in these samples is the depth, space, and tone of the synchron stage due to the seven different mic positions used to record them. It is extremely difficult to get an authentic tone from sample libraries not recorded with lots of mic positions. However, deeply sampled VSL instruments, like the Dimension Brass, can act as an effective complement to the Big Bang series. For those more familiar with legacy sample library techniques, think of it as you would layering string libraries, like how you would go about adding a little first chair solo strings for increased detail in the whole string section. This technique is necessary for melody in the upper register of the trumpet, especially when, according to my incomplete reduced score, they're playing A3. On the one hand, you want things in tune and punchy like the original recording. On the other hand, you want to avoid any synthiness in the note transitions, staccatos, or the note releases. I found many different recordings and various versions of the score. In question for me was the exact articulations, which notes specifically are slurred, which specifically are staccatos or tenutos, whether listening to the original movie score recording or subsequent performances actually conducted by John Williams, there's absolutely zero consistency between the versions and recordings. Even with a top orchestra like the London Philharmonic, the articulations in the first statement and the second statement are different. But hey, who cares? It's not a problem. The point is that you make a specific choice, and both the Big Bang trumpets, Copernicus, and the Dimension Brass trumpets must be the same. And I'm not talking about the specific articulation sample choice, but however it is you would perform a passage like this. Digging into the Big Bang trumpets, for the opening staccato and tenuto mark, I needed a less staccatissimo and a little more weight. So how do I do that? Well, I time stretch this bold patch so it's longer. At this tempo, the staccato is too short. It doesn't have this mid-tempo weight, nor the broad open O sound that all brass players try to achieve even in their upper registers. Well, especially in their upper registers. Utilizing the time stretch function here assists with achieving that sound. Staccatos, like, the word staccato doesn't mean short. It means space between the notes. Okay, let's talk about these slurs. The trumpets are going from an A natural to an F on the top of the staff. Is it marked with a slur in most scores you find online? Yes, but what do trumpet players actually do? The speed of the slur marking is determined by the embouchure adjustment, the speed of the valves, which for the C trumpet is first and second valve to first valve, so middle finger coming up. The air is bumped by the tongue to lock in the tempo of the slur, and a different amount of air to center the pitch and maintain tone and all that kind of stuff. But we're A3, so each player is going to get there at a slightly different time, and because of the range this melody is in, coming from a high B flat right before, this is a place that is typically rushed. And for evidence of that, check out the various live performances on YouTube. Given these realities, and because I wanted to maintain the brassy tone of the sforzatissimo, or however you say that in Italian, I opted for automating the attack parameter, covered by the more present release of these multi-mic sample libraries. This, coupled with the fast legato articulation of the Dimension Brass, blends into what the ear perceives as three trumpets in the high register doing a slur. A clean one, too. And this is the same principle throughout. what is the articulation indicated, and how do I use the Big Bang trumpets to get it? What needs to change tonally, lengthwise, or transitionally? Then, how I can add a little more detail with another library. I do not think I could make a recording of this Jurassic Park cue without the Big Bang trumpets. So in the next part, we're going to dive deeper into the programming and performing of these parts.